Mayweather's actually, he likes what McGregor's doing. He feels he took a page out of his book. Do you see that? Do you think he took something out of Mayweather's book there?
McGregor, he looked really sharp in that fight, man. Yeah. He was counter-punching. He did what he's supposed to do for sure, man.
In the sense how he sells the pay-per-view and the show.
Right, for sure, man. Yeah, he's a smart dude, man. He's a smart guy.
What do you think? Is he one of the smartest fighters to come around since Mayweather?
Who's that? Conor McGregor?
Yeah.
I don't know about that. I mean, I think he's one of the most entertaining fighters to come about since Floyd Mayweather. I mean, smart, it is what it is. I mean, whoever's undefeated right now and has not yet tasted defeat, I'm going to say smart. Conor McGregor's been beaten a few times, so, you know, he's got his flaws and mistakes.
Man, he does that shit.
Oh, yeah. No, there's nobody in mixed martial arts that sells fights like Conor McGregor.
Yeah, and as Top Rank used to promote a great fighter, Juan Manuel Lopez, you saw his last fight, man. What do you take to the ending of that grudge match that everybody's been asking for years, you know?
That's great. I mean, it was a great fight for the island of Puerto Rico, and it was two guys that had a lot of bad blood, and the ending is great, man. I love controversy. Anything that brings attention to boxing, whether good or bad, I think is good. And, you know, my boss, Bob Arum, will probably attest to that as well. So it's good. You know, Juanma, I fear for him. I think that's about the level he should be fighting right now. Because
he called out Mares and he wants the third Salido fight. I mean, he feels that he's back in form, man.
You've seen what Salido did to him those first two times. And Salido, he's on a different level, and I think he's going to hurt him. And I just think the same thing with Abner Mares, man. Yeah. I just think these guys, I think Juanma is not where he should have been right now. You know, he had all that hype when he was with Top Rank, and it just didn't pan out. So, you know, I hope he fights a little bit more like he's been fighting with Wilfredo Vasquez, Papito.
Yeah.
And, I mean, we'll see. But I don't want to see him with any of the top dogs. I'm afraid he'll get hurt.
What do you think, Gabe? Is he done? Does he not deserve a Salido fight or Abner Mares fight after that? What do you think?
Nah, man. Nah, I don't think so.
What would have happened if a fighter rushed you in the corner like that, man? How would you have to take things?
I'm going to take off. I'm going to take flight, so just like the other coach did.
Who was wrong in that case, man? A lot of people are blaming the trainer. Some are blaming Lopez. I mean, who do you think was wrong in that case?
I don't know. I only seen a little clip on Instagram, though, but Lopez looked like he ran towards the trainer, so I would have did the same thing. I would have swung on his ass, too.
Yeah.
And it looked like the trainer almost knocked his ass out, too, so I would stay away from the big dogs.
You'd stay away from the trainer as well?
Right.
Yeah, it was a flagrant, too, on behalf of Juanma.
Yeah, they got suspended for both of them. You think that's fair? I mean,
yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. There shouldn't be no shenanigans inside the ring. I mean, look, it's great, it's entertaining, and we all watched the clip on YouTube or wherever you've seen it, but it's there, in this business, there's no room for that. Derek Harmon. Ah! You see that?
Yeah, that's what he does, right?
He's right there.
That's what he does.
At the front, talking to Bob Bennett.
Oh, okay.
It's Derek Harmon, my main man.
How's it going? So introduce yourself to the fans.
Man, I work for Bob.
Derek Harmon keeps Mr. Bob Arum safe.
President of Black Lives Matter.
The president of Black Lives Matter.
You like that, don't you? No, I'm Derek Harmon. I work for Bob Arum.
Yeah. Is there any different atmosphere here compared to the previous Pacquiao fights? How do you feel about it? I mean,
I think it's more, I see more bodies here with the Pacquiao and Vargas compared to Pacquiao and Bradley. I think because of the large Hispanic group has come out to support Vargas. Yeah. So, yeah.
If you had to bet, who would you lay that bet on going into this fight Saturday?
The brown skin guy.
Yeah. Who's that? Who's the brown skin guy?
Both of them.